Hey, welcome to this interactive tutorial video where I'll be taking you through SciSpace's literature review tool. I'm not gonna lie, there will be a lot to unfold in this video, so feel free to pause, rewind slow or fast in the video at any point. But before we get started, I just wanna clarify, what exactly is a literature review? Say you've got a research project coming up and all you have is a vague topic as a starting point. The standard procedure is you need to find related papers, go through them, understand your topic, and finally come up with a research question before you can move on to conducting your research. Or in other words, do a literature review. Sounds a little overwhelming. Well, it really can be, particularly if you're a student or an early researcher. Don't fret, because enter SciSpace. More specifically, our literature review tool. Hey, this is Alex, and I'll take you through how our literature review tool works, its different features, and how you can utilize it to have a much easier time discovering and reviewing the scientific literature for your project. So, one of the bigger challenges you might face is starting out. While you do have Google Scholar, it's mostly useful if you know the title of a paper, not so much if you want to discover new papers. How SciSpace solves this problem is by showing you papers based on a topic or a question. Suppose you want to find papers related to the question, what is the significance of dark matter? You simply type it in the search bar, hit enter, and voila, find papers. Now, these papers are automatically sorted based on their relevance to your query, but you can always add filters like full PDFs, open access, year, and publication type. You can also sort the search results by citation, see newer papers first, or in alphabetical order. All this helps make the search more precise. So, you have the papers you want to read. Now what? Well, in addition to being just a search engine, SciSpace also shows you an overall insight from the top five papers. This changes as you add or remove papers from the search list. What this insight does is gives you an answer to your query and cites from which papers it took the answer. And for all the papers in the search results, SciSpace also shows you paper-specific insights, TLDR, conclusion, and other information in the form of columns. You can add from preset insights like methodology, practical implications, and limitations. Or if you want, there's this nifty little feature called custom columns where you can ask for a specific information from all papers. For example, you want to know the problem statement of each paper. All you have to do is enter it into the custom column section here. Now, mind you, these information bits are taken from the abstract of a paper, so if an abstract isn't clear enough, SciSpace's column might show NA. If you're wondering how these columns are useful, then two of the most obvious answers are, one, you don't have to read papers in its entirety at this stage. You can simply extract an insight. Now, I'm not advocating for not reading the full paper. You absolutely should if you want to understand it. But since we're in the review stage of the research, these insights can help you save a lot of time. And two, the second use of these columns is you see insights from multiple papers on one screen. Usually, you'd be going back and forth between tabs, jotting down your findings, and then comparing or contrasting different papers. SciSpace lets you do this in one place. Oh, and I almost forgot. If you're a non-native English speaker who sometimes struggles to understand extremely dense scientific jargon, you can choose from 75 languages to survey these papers. To get this right, you have a list of papers and you have all the insights from them. Based on this, you can now curate a collection by removing all the irrelevant papers. This collection is automatically saved, so you don't have to bother yourself. And if you want, feel free to export this collection as a .csv file for sharing with your colleagues. Hey, we are still not quite done yet though. At the bottom right of this screen, you see the thing called Copilot. If you're wondering what that is, it's this AI research assistant that explains and summarizes text, math, and tables in a paper. You can also ask follow-up questions, and it gives a contextual answer. We'll get into Copilot in another video, but when paired with our literature review tool, it allows you to ask questions on the top insights and papers in your collection. So if you're a little blurry on the topic and want to understand it better, feel free to ask Copilot any question. For instance, what are non-baryonic particles? This way, you can really dive into a topic or a paper and move faster towards understanding existing literature, which will help you form a more insightful research question. And that brings us to the end of the video. Go try the tool for yourself and do share your experience with us. If you have any more questions, please put them in the comments. We'll be sure to answer them. Until next time.